हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन आई एम हियर फॉर द एक्सरसाइज 5.1। एज यू नो दैट इन द प्रीवियस ऑफ आवर क्लास वी अंडरस्टूड दैट हाउ वी विल ड्रॉ हिस्टोग्राम एंड वी स्टडीड हाउ टू कन्वर्ट अ डाटा इनटू अ ग्रुप्ड डाटा। वी आल्सो स्टडीड दैट वी हैव स्टडीड बार ग्राफ, पिक्टोग्राफ एंड डबल बार ग्राफ इन प्रीवियस ऑफ आवर क्लासेस। सो Now we will there do solve question number 2 of exercise 5.1, in which we will have to make a frequency distribution table as well as we will have to draw the bar graph for that. Okay, what is question number 2 is saying? The shoppers who come to a departmental store are marked as men M, women W, boy B and girl G. The following list gives the shoppers who come during the first hour of the meeting. Make a frequency distribution table using tally marks. Draw a bar graph to illustrate it. So this is question number 2 of exercise 5.1. Okay. So let me draw the frequency distribution table and then we will draw the bar graph. So the person, then tally marks and then frequency. Okay, person are woman, man, boy, girl. Okay, so now we will keep putting the tally marks, that 1, 2, 3 women, so 1, 2, 3, then one girl. So, in front of girl, I will put a tally mark. One boy, then 1, 2 women. So, this is 4, this is 5. Man, girl, man. So, I am putting the tally marks according to the number of people visiting. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. One girl, one boy, one man, woman, boy, girl. So there is, as you know that this is the representation for 5. Then man, woman, 1, 2. Man, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Man. Then woman, boy, woman, girl, then man, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, one girl, woman, man, woman, then man. You can see that I'm simply putting a tally marks according to the number written. Then woman, girl, woman, man, girl, woman, man, boy, girl, and woman. So this way, these are the tally marks for the number of people, women, men, boys, girls, visited in the first hour of the shop, departmental store. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 28. 28 women have visited the departmental store in the very first hour. 15 men have visited, 5 boys and 12 girls. So this is the information we gathered from this data, and now we are going to convert it into a bar graph in which on the x-axis I will represent the person and on the y-axis I will represent the number of persons. on the x-axis I will represent person, on the y-axis I will represent the number of person. Now 28 is the maximum number, so what I can do, I can keep a scale of 1 centimeter is equals to 2 person. And what will be the heading? Bar graph for people visited in first hour. The number of people visited in the first hour will be represented on this bar graph. So this is a 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 4, 6, 8, 10. So this way I have marked. This is to be drawn on the graph paper. So on the graph paper you all will get this dark, in the dark line. So for women it is 28. So the first bar of ours will be up to 28, and this is representing women. Okay. Then the second bar is up to 15. So 15 will lie between 14 and 16. So in between of, there will be a gap of 1. And then this will be men. Men up to 15. Thereafter, boys. Boys are up to 5 only. So here are my boys. And the girls are 12. So 12 girls have visited the departmental store. Here are the girls. So this way, this is your bar graph for the given information. I am very sure this is clear to you, and this way your question number 2 is ready. Now in question number 3, there is the weekly wages given of some 30 workers, and then he is asking you to make the telemarks table first of all, and once the telemarks table is ready, then he is asking you to draw the histogram for that. Okay, this time we will have to draw the histogram because the wages will be in continuation, and he is asking us to make a grouped frequency distribution table. So first of all, let me write the data for you so that thereafter it will be easily done, or we can copy it from here only. Noting them down will take time. Chali. So we are on question number 3. The weekly wages of 30 workers in the factory is as follows. Using telemarks, a frequency distribution table with interval 800 to 810. He has told you this time. It is not necessary that he will tell you. So you will have to see that what is the minimum wages. I can see that the minimum wages is 806. No, 804. So 804 is the minimum wages, and what is the maximum wages? 890 I can see. 898. So 898 is the maximum wages. So 804 minimum, 898 maximum. So there we can make 10 groups of 10 rupees. Okay. So the first will be wages, then telemarks. And the third will be frequency. So wages will be 800 to 810. 810 to 820. So this way I will make 10 groups. I hope you can see. 820 to 830, 830 to 840, 840 to 850. 850 to 860, 862, 870, 872, 880, 882, 890, and in the end 892 900. And I am very sure that you remember that the rule of inclusive and exclusive, that 800 will come in this group, but 810 will not come. Where 810 will come? 810 will come here. 810 will come here, but 820 will not come here. Why? 820 is the upper limit, so 820 will come in the next group. So the lower limit is included, upper limit is not included. Look for the first observation. The first observation is 830. So 830 is here as well as here. So tell me where it will come. Yes, it will come here, because this is the lower limit. Second is 835. So 835 is lying in this only. So once again 835 will be here. Third is 890. So you tell me 890 present in both the places, but it will be come in the last one. Then 810. So 810 will not come here. 810 will come in the second of the group. Then 835. So 835 was already here. One more 835. 836. That is also going to come here. 869. So 869 will lie between 860 and 870. So it will come here. Then 845. 845 is lying in between of 840 and 850. 898. So 898 will come in the last group. Then 890. Once again 890 is going to come in this group only. Next observation is 820. So 820 will come here. Here is for 820. Then 860. So 860 should come between 860 and 870. Then 832. So 832 should go here. So here is the fifth one. 833. Once again. 855. So 855 will come here. Then 845. 845 once again between 840 and 850. 804. So 804 will come in the first one. Then 808, once again in the first group. 812, second group. 840, so 840 will come here. 885, so 885 will come between 880 and 890. It should come in this group. 835, two times. And 836. So 835 two times and 836 will also come here. Then 878. 878 will come between 870 and 880. Then 840. So 840 will come here. 868. 868 will lie between 860 and 870. 890 once again in the last group. 806 in the first group, and in the end the last observation is 840, so it will come here. So this way our frequency distribution table is ready. Let me write the frequency. 3 2 1 9 5 1 3 1 1 4. So these are the frequency of wages of 30 people, and your question number 3 is done. So in question number 3, only and only thing you will have to do is you will have to make this frequency distribution table. And once this frequency distribution table is ready, then in question number 4 he is saying draw a histogram for the frequency distribution table made for the data in question number 3. Whatsoever table you have made, with that table make a histogram. So let me draw the histogram now. This is question number 4, exercise 5.1. So what it is representing? Histogram for wages of workers. Histogram for wages of workers. Here I am going to draw a histogram. Now one more thing, new thing you will learn, that this is the origin. and origin is 0. That for x axis also it is 0, for y axis also it is 0. This is our x axis and this is our y axis. But now wages of ours start from 800. So what we will do, we will make a zigzag line. We will make a zigzag line for the first centimeter. And then we will start with 800. What does zigzag line says? That from 0 to 800 is not according to the scale. And thereafter it is according to the scale. So 0 to 800 it is without scale. 800, 810, 820, 830, 840, then 850, 60, 70, 80, 90, 900. As you can see that the continuous data is going on, so there is nothing but frequency histogram is to be made. And now what is the maximum frequency? That is 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It is 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What it is? Number of workers. And what it is? It is wages. Now what else I am going to write? I am going to write the scale on x-axis. There will be two scale. 1 centimeter is equals to 10 rupees. Here it is, 1 centimeter is equals to 10 rupees. And on y-axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 1%. So this way our background for the histogram is ready. Now let us start drawing. For 800 to 810, 3 people are there. So my building will rise up to 3 centimeters. Then 810 to 820 is 2. So building will come down up to 2. Then 820 to 830, 1. Okay. Then 830 to 840 is 9. So 830 will rise up to 9 and will go. So this way 840 to 830 to 840 is 9. Then 840 to 850 is 5. Where is 5? Here it is. 840 to 850. Then 850 to 860 is once again 1. 860 to 870 is 3. It will go up. 870 to 880 is 1. 880 to 890 is also 1. And then 890 to 900 are 4. So this way our histogram for the given data is ready. And this is question number 4 of exercise 5.1. I am very sure it is clear in your mind. This graph you will have to make in graph copy, okay? And no one of you will stick it. Please don't stick it in the main copy. Purchase a graph copy and draw it in that, okay? Now you will have to answer few questions in question number 4. Which group has the maximum number of workers? So the maximum number of workers, you can see that the tallest building is 830 to 840. So the maximum number of workers are under 830 to 840 group. How many workers on 850 and more? So that answer we can give from here as well as here. So 850 and more. So these many people are earning more than 850. They are earning less up to 850 and they are earning more than 850. So 1, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 4, 10. More than 850 is, the people earning more than 850 is, how many? 4, 5, 6 and 4, 10. These 10 people are earning more than 850. How many workers earn less than 850? So other than these 10, 9 and 1, 10 and 10, 20. So less than 850 आर अर्निंग 20. ओके, मोर देन 850 आर अर्निंग 10 एंड लेस देन 850 आर अर्निंग 20. सो दिस वे यू कैन आंसर द क्वेश्चंस एंड दैट यू कैन नो बाय द टेबल एज वेल एज बाय द ग्राफ दैट दिस मेनी पीपल आर अर्निंग अप टू 850. सो दीज आर द पीपल हु आर अर्निंग मोर देन 850. 1, 3, 1, 1, 4. ओके, नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. In question number 5, there is already a bar graph given and then you will have to answer the questions. Okay? You need not to draw the bar graph. Drawing of bar graph, we are having just one question in the book. So, with the help of that only, you will practice. Okay? Now, question number 5. Exercise 5.1. What it is saying? The number of hours for which students on a particular class watch television during holiday is shown in the given graph. Answer the following. You can see that on x-axis there is hours of TV watched per day and on y-axis there is number of students of the class. So 1 to 2 hour 4 students are watching, 2 to 3, 8, 3 to 4, 22, 4 to 5, 32, 5 to 6, 8, and 6 to 7, 6. Chaliye ji, dekhte hain what he is asking. For how many hours did the maximum number of students watch the TV? Sabse jyada kaun kitne ghante dekhte hain? So maximum is 32, and 32 is lying under the 4 to 5 hours. For 32 students watch TV for 4 to 5 hours. So the answer is 4 to 5 hours. How many students watch TV for less than 4 hours? So 4 se pehle ki jitni bhi building hai, make the sum of that and then you will get the answer. Less than 4 hours. So 8, 22, 32. Is it? And 4 also. No, 32 will not be added. With 4, 32. So 22, 8 and 4, 30 and 34 students watch TV less than 4 hours. How many students spend more than 5 hours in watching TV? So 4 to 5 ke baad wale jitne bhi hain. More than 5 hours. So there are only two buildings. One is 8, other is 6. So 14 students watch TV for more than 5 hours. I am very sure it is clear in your mind. And this way, exercise 5.1 of yours is complete. Okay? In exercise 5.1, we will be interested to know another type of representation of data which is called pie chart. Okay, so let me give you a brief introduction about pie chart and thereafter we will start it in the next of our lecture. So pie chart is simply the circle graph. It is also called circle graph. When you are dividing the whole circle into various heads, you can see that we have divided the circle into four groups. So let us say this is our we are making it on the monthly expenditure. This is for food. This is for education. This is for transport. And this is for entertainment. So this all depends upon the angles. Okay? We will have to convert everything into the angles. Okay? And once the angles are with us, then we can easily make our circle chart. So for this, converting every data into angles will be very important. In our next class, we will discuss about pie chart. So get ready to know about pie chart. Okay, complete your work till here. Thank you. Have a nice day.